Welcome to Logbook Checker and thanks for downloading the app. There's a number of things you'll need to do when you first start the app to set it up correctly. First thing that comes up is whether you want to start a new diary, which most people who are new to the app will choose, or if you've already been using the app, you can download a diary so you can transfer it from another device via Google Drive. So we're going to start a new diary. Now there's a few details here that we have to enter or change depending on what options we want. First thing is to put in your name. So we're going to stick in test driver as an example. And a bogus license number. License state, choose whichever state is your license state. And then now you've got a couple of options to choose from. There's a driver signature, we'll go through that in another app, how you add a driver signature. But we've got two old counting options here. And the default for them, as you see here, is probably the best way to leave it. I must point out though that old counting doesn't matter for if you're using WA rules. It won't change the way the app works at all. So the first option is how it counts for a 24-hour period when counting work and rest time. So if you have it turned on, what Logbook Checker does is it counts from the end of every break, minor or major. So even if you have a break for 15 minutes, it will count forward from the end of that break when counting work and rest time for a 24-hour period. We recommend having it turned off because what it does then is it counts forward from the end of a major rest break when counting work and rest time for a 24-hour period. So that's a 7-hour break or longer if you're solo, or a 5-hour or longer break can be non-stationary if you're driving two up. With it turned off, what that means is that your minor rest breaks for each day do not need to line up if you're right up on your hours each day. So that's the reason we recommend turning it off, which is perfectly legal. When we get to 7, 14 and 28 days, so 7 for standard hours, 14 for standard hours and BFM, and 28 days for if you're driving standard bus or standard coach. With it turned on, it will count forward from the end of any major rest break. That's a break that's 7 hours or longer for solo, or 5 hours or longer for two up. However, when you have it turned off, it will only count forward from the end of a 24-hour break, which is, if you look in the front of your driver work diary, this is perfectly legal. And that's the way they say you should count hours. So that means that you don't again have to line up the amount of hours you work each day. If you're right up on your hours, you don't have to line it up like, you know, what happened 14 days ago and how many hours you have available, because it will only count forward from the end of a 24-hour break or longer. The last thing is whether you have BFM, and the accreditation number here is actually the accreditation number for the company you work for. So that will appear on your, when it draws up the driver work diary. Having selected it here, must point out, does not mean that you are now using BFM. That is selected when you add or edit a log sheet, and we'll show you that when we get to that in another video. Now all we have to do now is to save those user details. Make sure they're correct, because you can't change particularly your name later. Hit save. It comes up with a screen showing the new features for the latest version. We can get rid of that